Today on the Slanted Lens, we're going to show you how to change the color of a shirt.
It's not that hard.
Before you watch this great lesson, get over to theslantedlens.com and sign up to win this $1,000 worth of lighting equipment from DynaLite. 400-watt pack, heads, umbrella, and a Timba case. Hi, this is JP Morgan.
And I'm Jolene Morgan.
Today, Jolene's going to start a new segment here on the Slanted Lens. She's going to show you retouching techniques. Jolene's a retoucher here in Los Angeles, has been retouching things for celebrities and for Sony and for Fox for years.
And I also retouch all of the images that JP shoots and the things we do here for the Slanted Lens and a variety of other design studios across the nation.
So today, Jolene's going to show us how to change the color of a shirt. Simple process?
It's a simple process, but if you don't know how to do it, you get really frustrated.
So let's get started.
And see what we can do. So the first thing you need to do when you want to change the color of a shirt or the color of anything is you need to mask it out. So then you can make color adjustments to what's showing. I like to use the quick selection tool. It's over here in your tool palette. So I select that and then I go to the item that I want to select and I just start going along the edge of it.
So as you can see, Jolene's not using her mouse. She's using her Wacom tablet. I like that. Wacom tablet.
It's really free-flowing and nice to use, but you don't have to have a Wacom tablet in order to do this. You can use your mouse, you can use your trackpad on your laptop. This is a really nice tool. Yeah, and see here, right here, it's selected the background. So you just select the option key, which gives you a little negative sign there, and then you can remove that from your selection. And right here around her hair, that's something that I would maybe want to finesse later, but I'm removing that from the selection right now. Okay, so then you go to your layer and you add the mask. You can double click on it and you get your properties. And there's a thing here called mask edge. If you click on that, it allows you to refine the edge of your mask.
Oh, so you see what it is that's masked out there.
Right. So you can make adjustments here on how the edge is affected. And this thing called decontaminate colors works well around edges of hair. There's a little thing here called Refine Radius Tool where you can go in here around the hair and then that will kind of feather in the edges of something like hair. Then you click OK and it refines the edge of your mask. Now I've masked out my shirt, and so what I want to do next then is make a color adjustment to the shirt. And I like to use what's called selective color. Down here in this area at the bottom of your layers palette, there's a little circle with a diagonal line through it. Down at the very bottom is selective color. You go to selective color and it gives you all kinds of options to adjust the color. Here there's a drop-down menu that lets you adjust reds, yellows, greens, cyans, blues, magentas, etc. So for this shirt, I'll just go to what I've already done here. You can see in the reds, I brought the cyan way up and the magenta way down because it was too purple. If I turn that layer off, you can see the difference. And I also went to the magentas and did something similar. Put the cyan way up and the magenta way down. I adjusted yellow a little bit, but still you can see that magenta is bleeding through. So I wasn't totally happy with everything that I could do on selective color. So then what I did, I put a solid color layer, which you can also get here on this drop-down menu. The top one is solid color, and I overlaid black. You can see how it's just a flat black. It just totally covers it up. But I took the opacity down to 41% and then put it on overlay, and overlay lets you see the details.
Lets you see through it?
Is that what you mean? So lets you see through it. And you should experiment with all these different blend modes is what they're called. Hard light works well here as also soft light. You can see still more of the magenta showing through. I left mine on overlay and 41%.
So just for fun, what if we want to make this shirt red?
So if we want to change the shirt to a different color like red, start out with your good mask. You go to this drop-down menu where you can select selective color or you can change it in hue saturation. And then what you want to do is you want to take your mask that's in your original layer and you want to add it to the selective color layer. So you hold down the Option key and drag your mask up to the selective color layer, and it asks you if you want to replace the layer mask, and you say yes. So now I've masked out this color, the selective color layer. And now I'm looking at this, and blue needs to be taken away or red needs to be added to make this to a red shirt. So I'm going to go to the blue layer, and now I'm going to pump up the magenta and take down the cyan. And I can do the same thing in the cyan layer, take down the cyan and pump up the magenta. And it's still not looking red to me, so maybe I need to add a little yellow. So I go to the yellow layer and I up the yellow, down the cyan, etc. So you have a lot of ability to do little adjustments to color here. If you want to do something that's a little faster and it can give you a whole variety of color looks, what you want to try is hue saturation. Again, at this drop-down menu down here on your layers palette, go down to this one called hue saturation. You want to do the same thing. You hold down your Option key and take your mask, select it on your layer that you have the mask, and pull it up into your hue saturation layer. So now you can click on the hue saturation. And here, the nice thing about this is you can decide, I'm not sure which color I want to make this shirt. I want to just look at a variety. So you can just drag this along and it gives you a whole variety of colors.
Green's nice.
So we can make your shirt green.
If you pull it all the way over to the red, will it just go red?
No, if you see red here on the hue saturation, it means that it's adding red to the color you already have.
Oh, okay.
It is easier, but if you have a particular color you're wanting to match, especially if you're wanting to match a Pantone color or something, in selective color you can adjust things very more finely. So that's what you need to do if you want to change the color of a shirt.
Not that hard if you know what you're doing. So keep those cameras rolling.
And keep on clicking.
Our stop motion download from Trisha Zemp has been one of the most popular downloads we have ever done, and Trisha's back with a longer 2.5 hour workshop, advanced stop motion techniques. You'll love the things she talks about, a tasty video, the B&H logo, some great techniques on how to light, how to use dragon frames. So get over to theslantedlens.com, check it out. Don't forget to subscribe to The Slanted Lens. Like us on Facebook. Tell your mother about us. Tell your mother's mother about us.